but it's also our day of heroism. This is our day of showing that no matter what happens, no matter what they throw at us, no matter what they shove at us, no matter where they try to lock us in or lock us out, we are still here and we are not going anywhere.
Around 11:45. Today is about us, not them. We don't want to engage in any shouting matches with them. If they try to disrupt us, which we expect that they will, we're going to calmly respond, potentially, with a number of protests that are handed out. We have protest sheets. If you don't have one, share with your neighbor. We don't want any individual participants to be peaceful. We want this all to remain calm. Yeah, everyone with me?
We will update you further.
Ibrahim Hussein
Abu Jam, 714, a neighborhood people's group,
Mahar Ramadan Salmi Sarabin Jam,
34 years old. The official warning came. Due to suspected terrorist infiltration, residents are advised to lock themselves inside.
Bring them home! 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 Bring them...
This is a day of mourning. This is a day of remembrance that's being desecrated. There is a time and a place to remember the loss in this conflict. That time and place today is for the Jewish people to remember what happened 1 year ago. So I don't have a lot to say, because I don't think we need to say very much. But in the midst of all the noise, I would just encourage you to look across at the beautiful...
We cannot capture the enormity of what we've experienced, and it cannot be our only response. Our fight against anti-Semitism, against hatred, which also goes without a word. We must take action. We must be vigilant in recognizing and confronting the anti-Semitism.
A dozen of your extended family members are killed. I cannot explain how earth-shattering it feels to process one loss, one death, and then get hit with another. A few months after my family members were bombed, I get the news that my cousin, an 18-year-old girl with the sweetest smile you'll ever see, died of starvation. A death that was entirely preventable. A death that still doesn't make sense to me. I see a part of myself in every bombed village, in the martyrs that share my name, and the olive groves that are destroyed. However, it is not enough to merely mourn our loved ones. We must honor their legacy by doing what is right, not what is popular, not what advances our careers, because that what we owe our martyrs, and that what we owe the people of Palestine, that is what we owe them.
Survivor of the Nova. a chance at all our martyrs, right? We dance, we laugh, we smile. My dad said,
pain. I was numb to my core. I told Maor to get off of me, to throw bodies on me, to check on my dad and protect himself. He did just that. I lay there under three bodies. I was silent. I closed my eyes and my ears. A few minutes later, we heard a vehicle approaching, and then we heard people running and screaming. Soldiers, it's our soldiers.
Fighting!